Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back to the Faith Revival. So we've talked about how iman can be of different levels. We've talked about where you want your faith to be. We've talked about doubts being natural. Nevertheless, we want to strive to a place where the Prophet ﷺ mentioned the best type of iman. He said, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, imanun la shakka fi. Faith in which there is no doubt. Faith that is certain. Faith that has conviction. Now here's the thing. This is where yaqeen comes in. Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said that al-yaqeen huwa al-imanu kullu. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud said, yaqeen is full iman. It's when iman has been fully realized in every way. What does that mean? Intellectually, I have fortified myself so much so that I don't have any holes in my intellectual certainty in Islam. Spiritually, I have so much tajruba, experiential iman, that I know now that what is the most rewarding experience to me and the most fulfillment that I achieve is through my faith. So I have no holes in my spirituality anymore. Loving people for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I find that those are the strongest relationships and that's the strongest love that I have. I start to fortify myself in all of these places until it reaches to as close to certainty as possible. And that yaqeen that Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu spoke about, Ali radiallahu anhu said that if I was to see heaven, I would not want it. If I was to see Jannah, I would not want it more than I already want it now. And if I was to see hellfire, I would not want to stay out of it as much as more than I already want to stay out of it now. Meaning that I've already developed that certainty before I even have to see it. Okay? So, ilm al-yaqeen before ayn al-yaqeen. Having that knowledge of certainty or that certain knowledge before even having to see it. As if I could see it. كَأَنَّهُ رَأْيُ عَيْنِ. As if it's right in front of me. I already have that type of conviction and that type of certainty. That's what we want to strive to where we can achieve what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the very beginning of the Qur'an. ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ. That this is the book in which there is no doubt. If you realize Al-Fatiha is asking Allah for guidance, Al-Baqarah is that you get to a place where there is no doubt. You want to get to a place where you don't have that anymore and where you have that conviction. The more certain you are in your iman, the more your iman will produce. And that connection was made. So I want to teach you all a dua that was made by Abu Darda radiallahu anhu. Abu Darda is one of the muftis of the companions. And he used to make this dua, make this supplication after his classes, after his durus. He used to say, Allahumma inna nas'aluka imanan da'ima. Allahumma inna nas'aluka imanan da'ima. O Allah, we ask you for everlasting faith. Imanan da'ima. Wa yaqeenan sadiqa. And true certainty. Wa ilman nafi'a. And beneficial knowledge. Allahumma inna nas'aluka imanan da'ima wa yaqeenan sadiqa wa ilman nafi'a. O Allah, we ask you for faith that is everlasting, certainty that is true, so conviction that is true, and knowledge that is of benefit, knowledge that is beneficial. Basically, you want to get to a place where your iman is producing in every single way, and you should ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He fortifies you in all of these different ways. And this is what we learn, that subhanAllah, intellectually, the more I convince myself of the intellectual proofs of Islam, the easier I find myself to commit to it. Spiritually, the more I realize its benefits in times of ease, the more my spirituality is going to hold in times of hardship. Knowledge, when I study the Qur'an and the Sunnah, and when I study Islam, with the intention of not just gaining information, but of connecting myself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with whatever I'm studying, then you have knowledge that produces the fruit of knowledge, which is khashya, which is that awe of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for everlasting faith. We ask Allah for certainty that is true. And we ask Allah for knowledge that is of benefit. Jazakumullahu khairan. See you all next time, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.